of theories of light, how extremes at certain angles to align events, how the source of all information determines every outcome, how we can reflect it to summon aliens using mirrored poles of light. When I asked him what the point of it all was, he didn't seem to hear me. Lying on the grass outside a tennis arena, he held my face towards the sun and started to cry.
You are the sign I've been looking for.
I can read a private message from God in the silvery vortex of your left pupil.
I disregarded this. Instead, I was impressed by the ease with which he rolled on top of me, slid his hands down the backs of my jeans, and used both palms to squeeze. All in front of a Mexican family picnicking on the lawn. He was the manager of an apartment complex in a part of town where the palm trees were sick. They were infested by a parasite that made them soft like bendy straws. And so they arched over the roads, buckling under the weight of their own heads, fronds skimming the concrete surfaces of buildings, poking in through open windows. And when the wind blew, they clattered and sagged, and you could hear them creaking.
Somebody should really cut these trees down. It's just not right.
I hated my boyfriend, but I liked the town. It was a crumbling, shadowy collection of bungalows and auto body shops. The apartment rose two floors above it all, and so I could look down and out into the valley, which was always covered in an orange haze. Everyone in the neighborhood had to walk around with their heads down on account of all the birds. Something in the trees attracted a strange breed of pigeon, black ones with bright red legs and sharp gold-tipped talons.
They're Egyptian crows. They've been sent here to watch us. We've got to behave more careful than ever, babe.
Every morning, he went out to power hose all the bird droppings off of the French stoop, which were green and fluorescent. He hated those birds. He hated them. They were circling overhead constantly, hidden cop cars, and they stood in thick lines on the electric wires.
I noticed you spilled some coffee on the table. I cleaned it up for you. Aren't you gonna say thank you?
Thank you. Stay in shape.
You have to tense your body vigorously doing all everyday activities.
He walked around with buttocks clenched, arms rigid, neck and face turning red. When I first moved in, he ran up the staircase with my luggage and then stared down at me as though I would applaud. One time, he caught me looking at his arm and he said,
I'm basically an Olympic athlete, except I don't like to compete.
He had a crudely drawn tattoo of a salivating dog on his shoulder. Underneath it was written,
coming to get you.
I walk like a cop at night to scare off criminals.
Right.
Why do you think I've never been mugged?
He made me ugly. I had never dated an ugly man before. The thought passed my mind, perhaps I'm learning humility. Perhaps this man is the answer to my prayers. Perhaps he's saving my soul. I should be grateful. His legs were ironed, by the way. His hamstrings were so tight that he could barely bend at the waist, and when he tried, he made a face like he was being penetrated from behind. I should be grateful, but I was not grateful, and I was not kind. The only smile he ever gave was one where he lowered his head, tilted his chin out, and then spread the corners of his mouth from ear to ear, eyes twinkling up idiotically through batting eyelashes. He was, after all, a professional actor.
One day, I'm lying in love. Most actors who get famous too quickly are doomed.
You're so right.
But babe, when I get famous, I'm gonna take you out on the town and get you a nice steak dinner and wear my red jacket. Have you seen my red jacket? Oh, I got it at a vintage boutique. It's really expensive. It's really nice.
I'd seen it in the closet. It was a size 8 contemporary woman's blazer. Show me.
What do you think?
You look very nice.
One day, babe, I'm gonna take you to Vegas and marry you. I gotta get my mother's approval. But baby, I love you. I love you so much! Ah! My button! Where's my... Did you see my... Where's my button? Oh! Oh God! Oh! 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 I think I'm gonna go to the post office and get some mail.
You'll do great.
Thanks, babe.
Trash, lining the balconies, purring like tapped between the succulents. I watched as one walked towards me with a candy bar wrapper in his beak. He dropped it at my feet and then seemed to bow forward, spreading his wings wide, showing me the beautiful rainbow sheen of his jet black chest. He flapped his wings gently with subtlety, and he rose from the ground. I thought maybe he was trying to seduce me. I got up and walked away, and he continued to hover there, suspended like a puppet. Got back from the post office 2 hours later.
One of those birds shot on my face. It's a sign for sure.
You should get cleaned up. Your agent called.
Really? Did he say what it was for? Did I get an audition?
A beer commercial?
Oh.
Your face.
Oh. I'll clean it up. Hey, we're gonna be rich! Up on you. That's why I'm good on camera. Non-threatening.
You're so true.
Yeah, and hey, my face changes every day. I mean, one morning I can wake up, you know, boy next door. And the other mornings I can wake up as like a stone cold killer. You know, it changes by night. Just a natural born actor.
True enough. I had a bad feeling about what my boyfriend brought back from the post office. The box sat on the bed, unopened. What's inside?
Open it up, babe. Shoot the birds.
Why don't I deal with this? Shoot the birds. You do enough around here. Unless you would actually enjoy shooting those birds.
What? No! What? No! What? I would hate that. No. Oh, thanks, babe. Yeah. Hey, thanks for your support.
The vacant apartment by the time the woman showed up to see it in the afternoon. I found her wandering around back by the pool, eating a huge bag of Utz potato chips.
The woman was older, very tanned and fat, and had long salt and pepper hair parted in the middle. She moved gently, like dancing to soft music. She wore a lot of turquoise jewelry, had something tattooed on her forehead between her eyes. That tattoo on her forehead was like a third eye. It looked like a diamond on its side with a star inside of it. I stared at it for a second too long.
We love it here. We'd like to move in right away. Are you the manager?
I'm the manager's girlfriend.
But don't you want to see the place first?
I don't need to see it. I already know. Just show me where to sign.
These are the forms.
I would like to pay for a year's worth of rent in advance. That's how serious I am about renting this apartment.
I'll let the owners know. I'll let you know as soon as I can, Mrs.
Moon! Moon Kowalski.
I got you some ammo to shoot the birds.
Call your agent, Doc.
I knew it, babe!
I let him peel my shirt up to my throat, twist the fabric until he could use it like a rope to pull me up towards him. He unzipped his shorts. It's true, I relished him in certain ways. There were people I could have called, of course. It wasn't like I was in prison. I could have walked to the park, the coffee shop, or gone to the movies or church. I could have gone to get a cheap massage or my fortune told. But I didn't feel like calling anyone or leaving the apartment complex. So I sat, and I watched my boyfriend.
Outside, the palms shimmied and cowered in the breeze. I didn't want him to be happy. I closed my eyes and prayed for a natural disaster, an earthquake, a drive-by shooting, or a heart attack.
Don't touch that! Great! Now I gotta find a body of water to wash this in. I told you, don't touch my stuff!
You never said I couldn't touch your stuff. There's a pool outside.
Hey babe, I'm at the callback. I'll be staying out late for the lunar eclipse. Don't wait up for me. I forgive you for touching my crystal skull. I love you. I love you so much. When we're both dead, baby, we will meet on a long river of light, and there will be slaves there to row us in a golden boat to outer space and feed us grapes and rub our feet. I promise, baby. Pinky swear. Also, please let me know if my agent is called yet. I love you.
Who is it?
It's Moon! I'm here with cash and a moving truck. Ooh, 1 minute.
Like I said, I couldn't wait.
Is there a moving truck back there?
What is that? It's a buck. I love this buck. It's a good buck. No?
Do you want help?
Watching as Moon carried in a large, potted plant, I felt hopeful, as though it were me moving it, starting a new life. I stuffed the money Moon had given me at the bottom of my suitcase, cleared out my drawer, my boyfriend's makeup case, wrapped the shotgun in an afghan, and zipped it all up. Then, I helped Moon carry her old mattress out to the curb. We set it up against a tree trunk and watched the tree veer back precariously towards the apartment complex. A cluster of crows sprang out from his lead. When the truck was empty, Moon told me to sit down in the kitchen and rubbed the seat down with a rag.
You must be tired. Let me find my coffee pot.
No, I should get going.
No, you shouldn't. Be my guest. Want saltines?
You can paint the place, you know.
My boyfriend hasn't really done it yet. He's supposed to already, but that's just my boyfriend.
The manager guy. How long have you two been a couple?
Not long. I'm leaving him tonight, actually.
Let me ask you one thing. Is he good to you?
I lie. He beats me. And he's really dumb. I should have left him a while ago.
I have something for you.